So we just looked at two examples of websites who use their own internal APIs to resolve new data for their users. This is really cool, but unless you're already working for a giant web app, you probably don't have a massive internal database of cool information you can query asynchronously. But luckily, there are tons of APIs available on the web that readily serve up interesting information. And they're usually free to use, so long as you aren't making thousands of requests per hour.
For instance, Google offers a ton of APIs, including Google Analytics, Google Maps, Google Fonts. Looking around the web, it isn't hard to find examples of websites that use external APIs to create interesting interactions for users. Reddit and the Reddit Enhancement Suite Chrome plugin interact with a few different APIs to make Reddit feel more dynamic. When a user clicks on a link that resolves to a YouTube video, Reddit opens up an embedded YouTube player, which interacts with the YouTube API. Or when a user opens up a link to a Twitter feed, the Reddit Enhancement Suite Chrome plugin fires off an AJAX request for Twitter data and uses the Twitter API to open up the tweet right here inside the page. Check out the link in the instructor notes if you want to find some more APIs that are available.